Have you ever wondered what the difference between a freeze and frost is? Well, look no further, as the forecasters at the National Weather Service in Monterey describe the difference. As we approach the cold weather season, it is important to know the difference in how to protect yourself from the cold. So what exactly is frost? Frost describes the formation of thin ice crystals on the ground or other surfaces in the forms of scales, needles, feathers, or fans. Frost develops under conditions similar to dew, except the temperatures of the Earth's surface and earthbound objects fall below 32 degrees. Frost can harm sensitive plants during the growing season, which is usually before mid-November and after March 1st. However, frost can be damaging even outside of the typical growing season. Did you know that frost can form when temperatures are a few degrees warmer than freezing? A more detailed explanation of frost formation will occur in later slides. A freeze is when the surface air temperature is expected to be 32 degrees or below over a widespread area for a significant period of time. These events can be life-threatening and can be damaging to plumbing and vegetation. So when exactly do temperatures usually fall to 32 degrees? Pictured here is a table which displays numerous locations through the area and when temperatures usually fall to the freezing mark. In general, parts of the North Bay as well as southern Monterey and San Benito counties fall to near freezing late October to late November, while elsewhere it usually hits 32 degrees in December. One question asked by a Facebook follower of the Eureka National Weather Service office was, how does frost form? Good question. First, the air temperature needs to fall to the dew point temperature. This allows dew or small water droplets to form. If dew forms on an object that is at or below 32 degrees, frost will form. One interesting note, though, is that frost can form even if the air temperature is above 32 degrees, as long as the object it forms on is at freezing. The other night in Monterey, frost formed on a roof where the surrounding air temperature was 38 degrees. How exactly should you prepare for the cold weather this winter? Listed here are a few cold weather safety tips from our friends at the California Emergency Management Agency. Prepare your family by moving plants and animals inside, out of the elements. Also, never bring heating devices inside your home that are meant for outdoor use. This can cause fatal carbon monoxide poisoning. Dress for the weather. Wear layers instead of wearing just one big heavy layer of clothing. Travel with caution. Make sure you always have at least half a tank of gas. Lastly, recognize symptoms of exposure, such as dizziness, exhaustion, and shivering. Thank you everyone for listening to this presentation. Feel free to contact us on Facebook or Twitter. We will try to answer any questions you may have regarding frost and freeze.